Hi everyone, welcome back to another video on DBT. In this video, we will take a look at a critical function of DBT, which is tests. And as it says here, tests are assertions that you make about your models and other resources in your project. And I like to think of them almost like unit tests in a way. And this is really useful because you can test individual sources, you can test models, and it really helps you get a head start on the QA process that usually in analytics can be kind of tedious to take care of. DBT makes this a little easier to work with and get around this problem. You'll generally have two different types, schema tests and data tests. And out of the box, it ships with a couple specific tests, unique, not null, accepted values, and relationships. You can also create your own custom tests if you want. There's a lot of customization that you can do here. For the sake of this video, we'll just take a look at how one of these tests work, how it compiles it under the hood, and then you can get an idea of how all the other ones are working and start to grow your test cases off of that. So let's hop back into VS Code, into this example demo DBT project that we've been working on throughout this series. And if we look at our schema YAML file, we can see here that in the column descriptions, we have tests, unique, not null here, as well as here. And this is for this specific column. So in this case, we're saying this column must pass these two tests. You can also have these tests on the whole model itself, not just an individual column, along with a couple other places. The way this is interpreted is this is saying this column should, when we run these tests, it should be unique and it should be not null. So it's going to run a script to validate that that is true and that there are no records that have, a non-unique value or a non or that there is a null value. If any of those happen, this test is going to fail. The way that we run tests is dbt test. Before, if you remember, we would do dbt run to actually run and deploy the models. And now dbt test will actually run these test cases, not deploy the models. So let's see what happens here. It recognizes the four tests, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we can see three of them passed, but one failed. And it gives you the result here. It says failure in test not null for the schema compiled here. So what this is saying is the not null test failed, meaning there must have been a null value in this data set where we're saying that's not allowed. So let's look at the script for this model, my first DBT model here. This is just one of the example models that comes with DBT when you initialize it. And you can see here, we're saying select one and then union with select null. And this is really done on purpose, I believe, to show how a test can fail. They're saying here you can actually remove it. So what's happening here is this null value is being inserted into this table. And then when we run the test, it's saying, actually, you can't have a null. So that's why it's failing. But how does it know that? Similar to how we looked where models are compiled in a previous video, DBT will also compile all of the test cases so that you can go and review what happened and see what logic was actually run. And you can either control click on this here and it will bring up that file directly if you're using Visual Studio Code, or you can traverse through these folders here, get to target, compiled, and you can see these test cases are in here, schema tests, coming from this file. And the one we are looking at is this particular one. So that's the same file. And here's a script that's running. It's compiling this and saying, count in this model where ID is null. And the expectation is this should be zero. But if there's anything other than zero, then this fails. And you can see here, got one result, expected zero. And we know just from looking at the script that we are specifically putting in a null value. But this is really useful when you have a larger data set or you're working with more real-time data and you want to test to make sure consistently that there is no null value, let's say in this case. And by running this test, you can get ahead of that and catch it, maybe before it gets to the reporting layer or for some user to see. And this is helpful because it's an actual script that we can run in our data warehouse. So if I go to my data warehouse here in Snowflake and drop in this script, we can see validation errors, there's a one here. And if we wanted to see what the actual value was, you can get rid of the count. and see what the actual value was, which we know it should be null, right? Now, if we wanted to correct this, and we don't want this to fail, there's two things we could do. We could either get rid of this test case and say, okay, we're allowing nulls, or we filter this out here just like they suggest and say, let's only take it where it's not null. So let's save this dbt run again so that we'll redeploy all these models. This deployed successfully, and now we can do another dbt test. And we would expect these all to pass now because that null value is being kept out. And they all pass, so that's great news. We corrected the error. And we can move forward. That's it for this video. I just wanted to show you how test cases are defined here in the YAML files, how they are compiled under the target folder, just like model queries are as well, and how you can check for them in the actual data warehouse itself to help debug the test case and be able to correct your errors. So thanks again for watching. Hope you found this useful, and I'll see you at the next video.